into the story of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, it begins with the mentioning of the devil. In the middle, the devil is mentioned. And in the end, the devil is mentioned. In the beginning, Allah Almighty says that Yaqub said to his son, لا تقصص رؤياك على إخوتك فيكيدوا لك كيدا إن الشيطان للإنسان عدو مبين. Oh my son Yusuf, don't tell your brothers about the dream you had because they will plot against you. Indeed, the devil is an enemy of man. You go to the middle of the story of Yusuf, which you all know. Yusuf alayhi salam told one of the inmates of the prison who was going out, اذكرني عند ربك, please make mention of me to your master. Maybe I will come out of the cell as well. What happened? فَأَنْسَاهُ الشَّيْطَانُ ذِكْرَ رَبِّهِ. The devil made him forget. It's that devil again. And then in the end of the story, when Yusuf alayhi salam is reunited with his brothers again, what does Yusuf say? وَجَاءَ بِكُم مِّنَ الْبَدْوِ مِّن بَعْدِ أَن نَزَغَ الشَّيْطَانُ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ إِخْوَتِي. It was the devil who separated between me and my brothers. Allahu Akbar. Therefore, the matter of the devil is real and the matter of the devil is serious. And when we speak about the topic of shaitan, it is not a diversionary topic. It is not a scapegoat of a topic, but rather we are nailing the problem on the head. Shaitan is the root of all problems. Shaitan's project is long term. Therefore, he works in stages, as Imam Ibn Qayyim says. He will first try and push the Muslim to shirk, to disbelief, to associate partners with Allah. This is the chief of all crimes. If he fails in doing that, he will drop a gear and he will work with the second best. He will try to occupy the Muslim with innovations, newly invented matters in Islam. If he is unable to do that, he is dealing with a Sunni, resilient, practicing Muslim. He drops a gear and he tries the next best. He tries to occupy that Muslim with al-kaba'ir, the major sins, like alcohol and interest and disobeying the parents and missing even a prayer. If he is unable to do that, he drops a gear, he drops a notch again, and he works with as-sagair, the minor sins. If he is unable to get these minor signs to be adopted by that Muslim, he drops a gear again. Look, subhanAllah, he doesn't give up. And he tries to occupy the Muslim with al-mubahat, the permissible things. He's not committing a sin, but he could be doing something better. If he is unable to occupy the Muslim with the permissible things even, to distract him from the more important things, he occupies him with certain good deeds that are lesser in weight than bigger good deeds. This is shaitan. Allahu Akbar. Furthermore, know very well, my brothers and sisters, that this devil, this open enemy, does not employ a one-size-fits-all technique on people. Rather, he studies his prey. And he approaches people according to their own individual weakness. So he will misguide the businessman via the avenue of wealth. And he will misguide the scholar via the avenue of knowledge. And he will misguide the ignorant person via his own ignorance. And he will misguide the public speaker via the avenue of fame. And he will misguide the young man via the avenue of women.